Hey guys, this is Sheldon and I'm doing a one-shot video, meaning I'm not going to spend 15 hours trying to produce a 4 or 5 minute video, but I want to explain my experience in changing my master cylinder. What we see here is a 2005 Mazda, and when I bought it, the brakes would go all the way to the floor, the brake pedal. I could not pump it up or anything, it would just go to the floor. The car somehow was still stop, but the pedal went straight to the floor. So what I did is I changed all the rotors and the pads on all four tires. And when I was done, the pedal would still go completely to the floor. And I put a post on the car flip group, and people suggested it was the master cylinder that was the issue. So this is the master cylinder, and the master cylinder is attached to a booster back here, and this is the new cylinder. I've already put it on the car, but the booster was very wet, and so that should have been an indication to me that when I pushed on the pedal, fluid was leaking from the master cylinder, meaning that it was the problem. So I bought a new master cylinder, and I'm going to go through how I installed it. This is the old master cylinder. We will pretend that it is the new one. And what I did is I bought a Dorman kit, a brake bleeding master cylinder bleeding kit. Dorman brand. And what you do is you set your new master cylinder up in a vise, and then you put in the fitting. You can see here the Dorman kit comes with several fittings, and you put in a fitting in each port. These ports were covered with the little blue thing there. You put in a fitting, attach a hose, and run the hose back into the reservoir, and you want to put the hose deep enough that it is completely covered, submerged, when you fill this up with fluid. Anyway, you do the same thing on both ports. Put in their fittings, put in the hoses, and once you have those in place, you fill up the master cylinder with the fluid, and then you start pumping the rod back here. And as you do that, you're going to pump air through the system, and you'll be able to look at the hoses there and see the air bubbles coming out, dumping into the fluid that the hoses are submersed in. So you keep pushing on that rod. I read where you don't want to push it more than an inch or so as you keep pumping it, but basically what you're doing is pushing the air through the reservoir, and you keep doing it until you keep pumping the rod until it appears that no more of those air bubbles appear out of the end of the hoses. Now, when you are done, you leave everything intact. Leave the red fitting and the hoses intact. Pull it off of your vise here and bring it over to the car. Now, what I did in preparation for this is I had removed, there's a bolt that is holding my master cylinder onto the booster. I completely removed that bolt, and then there's another bolt. I completely removed that one. I also loosened the two fittings to the brake lines, and then remove this electrical, probably some kind of a sensor or whatever. Anyway, I had done this prior to bench bleeding my new master cylinder. So when I brought over the new master cylinder with the bleeding kit still attached, I finished loosening the brake lines and removed them from the old master cylinder. and I brought them out of the way. I then completely removed the old master cylinder and put the new master cylinder on. When you pull, or at least when I pulled the master cylinder away from the booster, there was absolutely no brake fluid leaking. None of it came out. When I removed the brake lines, I probably lost a few drops, you know. So there, in other words, there was not a massive mess. So I attached and bolted the new master cylinder into place. Then I removed one of the red fitting screws, and when I pulled it out, I stuck in the brake line, tightened it down, and I removed the other red fitting from the bleeding kit and stuck in the brake line and tightened them both down. And the last thing I need to do, which I haven't done yet, is bleed the brakes one more time. And I believe the reason that we bench bleed a master cylinder is so that when we go to bleed the brakes, it doesn't take forever because we've eliminated a lot of the air already while the master cylinder was out of the car. But I can tell you, I got in the car and tested it, and I have a lot of brake pedal now. It's it does not go to the floor. So this was a success, and I hope this video helps somebody. Thanks.